Sure. My name is Michael Rosenblatt, and I'm the founder and CEO of Adams.
Awesome. Thank you so much. So what do we have here in front of us?
So these are a bunch of our first rev prototypes that we built for the Kickstarter campaign. And we designed Adams to make it really easy for people to make things that do things. And so so we'll enable people to make toys with Adams, but also they can be used in applications for makers. So so you can actually do larger scale projects with them as well. And we have a few examples of what we showed on the Kickstarter video. So so the blue atoms are sensors, and the red atoms are connectors or logic, and then the green atoms do things. And so so we have a light sensor and an accelerometer, and then this one's just a knob. And for the red atoms, this is actually a Bluetooth 4 brick, so you can control any of the atoms from an iOS device. And there's a flip-flop module that holds state and lets you turn things on and stay on. And then a splitter module, so you can break out to multiple atoms. And then the green ones are the ones that do things. So this one's a motor, and this one is a record and playback module, so you can actually record a message and it'll be triggered by another atom. And then this is just a LED light. So I can and then this is actually a battery pack, so it's very similar to the Bluetooth brick, but doesn't have the Bluetooth. Just the Bluetooth has a battery built in.
Sure.
Right. So so here I can show you how you can build something really easily. So this is the light sensor, and I'm gonna plug that into the battery, and now the more light that it detects, I'll use this flashlight here. Oh, okay, got it. Okay, so the more light it detects, the faster the output signal blinks, and you can see when it's head on, It's fully saturated, so it's on solid, but a little bit of light and it'll blink slow.
Yep.
And it pushes that signal through the battery brick into one of the green atoms. So if I plug that into the motor, and then I have an output shaft, so you can kind of see what's going on. The more light it gets, the faster the motor goes.
Yeah.
And the same will be true for anything you plug into it. So if you have just the LED module plugged into it, then the more light I show to the light sensor, the brighter that gets. And if you want to do both, then you can plug this into the splitter, and you can have the LED module and the motor going at the same time. Here, we probably have enough charge there to go for a few minutes. So the neat thing is that the blinking on the signal actually gets carried through the whole system, and that's how people will know how things are reacting. So you have this visual real-time feedback to whatever's happening. You can see there on the splitter, it's blinking also. And then when I shine the light directly on the sensor, it goes full on.
So you get feedback at each level.
Yeah, the feedback propagates through the whole chain.
Okay.
So we can switch the sensor. And this one's an accelerometer, and it's inside. It's basically just a mass on a spring, and if I tilt it, then it's actually that mass is being pulled down on the spring by gravity, and it's actually designed such that it's a 2G accelerometer. So you actually need twice the force of gravity to go full speed. But you can actually get that if you hit it. You can see how. It's responding, the signal intensity is responding to me pumping the sensor. It's actually also the same sensor. It's the same sensor in your iPhone to detect pan and tilt.
Yeah.
But it's also the same sensor in an airbag system.
Okay.
So you can see actually, I'll simplify this and just use the LED. You could have a toy car, and every time you bumped into a wall with it,
yeah,
you know, you would
get a flash.
Flashing. Yeah. You'd be flashing, you know, or you'd trigger the airbag. So it's kind of neat because kids can kind of understand how some of those sensors work that, you know, they see in movies or they interact with on a day-to-day basis.
Absolutely.
So these are some of the prototype parts for what comes with the iOS kit. And so the iOS kit comes with two motors that are inside here. One's driving the right track and one's driving the left track. And then the Bluetooth brick has a bunch of outputs and a few inputs, so you can read any of the inputs from the iPhone or iPod, and you can control any of the outputs. And so it works with all the other atoms. It's just it basically accesses a signal source, and you're controlling that signal from the iOS device. So we'll put it down there, and then I'm gonna pair to it. And so it sees the brick there, and then we'll just check to see which outputs are being controlled by these sliders. So so the left slider's controlling those, so we'll plug that into this track. And just make sure that it's going the way that we want. Oh, okay, I see. So the wires actually are to this motor controlling that track. So I'll hold it this way. And I want it to go towards you when I slide it up towards you, so I'll actually reverse these wires.
Yep.
And good. And then now we got it. And then same thing for the other track.
Mm-hmm.
So it's these two.
Yep.
And plug these in here. And check the direction. Yep, so we're good to go. And then I'll take it off the charger. And
nice.
And now you can control it from your iOS device. Now, if you wanted to add something else, then
sure, we just add another output.
Yeah, so the deluxe iOS set actually comes with an infrared transmitter that looks very similar to this. And when you hit the trigger button, it shoots the IR laser, and then and then you can receive that with an IR target, and that's what triggers the exploding brick.
Activate anything on that end of the world.
Right. Yeah, and I think we just ran out of juice there. So it had about 30 seconds of charge.
Yeah.
So all the modules, we've designed them so that, of course, they have the real-time feedback with the light-up input and output icons.
Yep.
But they also have these holes in the corner, so you can bolt them down to things if you wanted to use it for a science project. Or you could sew it onto something, like a Halloween costume. And then on the underside, they have Lego all the way around the perimeter, so Lego compatibility with the studs, and then they have Velcro on the middle. And then all the Atom sets also come with Velcro stickers, so if you want to actually stick headlights down to your Barbie Hot Wheels car, your Barbie Corvette, then you can do that. You know, you can actually add them to other toys.
Sure.
So, and then our last announcement in the Kickstarter campaign is we'll actually be hardening these and making them waterproof, including a waterproof connector system. So if kids want to use them outside in the rain or even in the bathtub, then they'll be robust to that. So
even the power and everything will be waterproof.
Yeah, the power is actually carried through the connectors, and yeah, we'll yeah, we have power and signal on each connector, so we'll actually waterproof that too.
Wow. So
built submarines.
Yeah, you built submarines or an iPhone controlled sailboat.
Yeah.